Welcome back to Let's Play the Outer Worlds. Blind, I forgot about this. Loading the world. In a new patch now, a new version, 1.2.0.418, according to the Epic Games launcher. We have some new settings. If I'm correct here. Okay, why am I on this resolution? I thought so. Let me just restart recording. I thought my FPS indicator looked big. I mean, you guys can't see it, but it's up here. And it looked a little bigger than normal. I don't know why it changed the resolution on me. Kind of wonder if it's anything else has changed. Chromatic aberration. This was added with this patch. Show chromatic aberration effect. These effects distort and shift the colors on screen, which may be uncomfortable to some. Oh, distort and shift the colors. Not sure why you'd want to do that. I mean, maybe for a special effect kind of thing. I really don't know. Let me know. It's on by default. Let me know if it's uncomfortable for you for any reason. And the other thing is head bobbing. That's probably under gameplay. Bark subtitles, semantic subtitles. So you see if anything else is different here. Right. I'm not sure. I know controller sensitivity is a new thing. I'm not sure about mouse. Controller sensitivity, that's new. I'm not using a controller, though. So I can just skip all this stuff. Enable cinematic kill camera, that's been added. When you kill enemies under certain conditions, disable. Yeah, I want that on. Head bobbing. We'll see. If that's annoying, I don't know. Sometimes it looks stupid with it on, and sometimes it looks stupid without it. I don't know if... I'm assuming having it off is just going to look the same way it normally does, and no change there. I guess we're good here. Alright. Okay. Parvati and Ellie we have. Okay, so we need to go on. We need a few things we need to do here in the unreliable. Check in on everybody. Check out their quarters and stuff. Just generally being no. Nosy, you have acquired the modern steel wrench.
Where are we headed today, Captain? The stars are the limit.
OSI prayer beads. Are these items? Hoop? I stole the hoop, didn't I? That's a ring. Huh. I got something like a hoop. Oh, I can add a consumable now. Okay. Yeah, I want to be doing that. This heals 25% health over 2, so we've got that. This is natural health regeneration. So if I add this, then we get a 2-second heal of 25% health, and then also 200% health regeneration. It's got to be good, right? Medical. This is if I get our medical up. Yeah, it's a... I'd say that's a good thing. We'll get some health back and then regenerate the rest, right? I have 11 of those. Bread. So I've got an inhaler thing with bread in it. Felix. Okay. So he's got a grenade launcher. Nice. Hope that doesn't harm friendlies. Not sure if it would. He's got that toss ball stick. I can give him perks. Increase your... Sorry, guys. Increase your persuade skill when Felix is in the party. So I can increase or decrease his threat. Let me just give him health for now. 30% base health. Increase the damage dealt by this companion using ranged weapons. Armor rating. Melee damage. 20% damage. Let's take the ranged damage. He's got nothing else, right? Yeah. Apply. Okay. That's stuck there. I don't know what happened. Okay, so he needs better armor. That's what he needs. Which means I need to get better armor because I don't have anything. Alright. Guess we gotta go shopping or something. And Ellie, I already have her set. Vicar Max can level up? Okay. Increase the duration of your dialogue combat effects. Dialogue, actually not really sure. Is that like to persuade somebody or intimidate? Dialogue combat effects. I kind of like the idea of that. I kind of want to increase his range as well, but we can do this. Why not? Okay. We got Steph. Let me just save those changes. I guess I'll go around and talk to everybody. Hi.
Hey, Captain. Can I get your temperature on something real quick?
My temperature? Is the ship about to blow up or something?
What? No. If it were, I'd be hollering loud enough to wake the dead. So, June Lei and I have been talking some. Through messages, I got him here on my datapad, and well, she sent me a poem.
What?
One she wrote her own self, I'm pretty sure. I don't know if I should read into it. Because poems are all symbolic and such, right? It's not so good. But real sweet.
What is going on here with you and her? poems. I'd just take a guess that Parvati's not an expert on poems, really. Comes from the heart, you'd say?
Oh, law. That's what's got me spooked. I don't rightly know. It's about this engine that's been shaking itself apart. Then this lady mechanic comes by and lays one hand on it. And the trouble goes away. It sings. I don't want to get too hopeful, but I'm wondering if maybe she's the engine and I'm the lady? It's a real romantic poem. It made my chest hurt, kinda.
Well, she doesn't... I'm not real clear on this, but she knows that... I mean, she doesn't... hasn't known her before? Just heard about her? I don't really... I'm not sure what this is... have to do here. this crew needs you. You should focus on your work, Parvati.
Yeah, okay. Deep breath. Maybe I just got a little squish for a minute.
That's a quest.
But yeah, there's other stuff needs doing. Thanks for the talk, Captain. I was real out of sorts. I feel better now.
Do you really? Do you really feel better? You don't look like you feel better. Sapphire wine. Says complete, but this is not checked off. Thanks to your introduction, Parvati and Junlei hit it off. Check in with Parvati back on the ship to see how things are progressing between the two of them. You have to give him the data cartridge. I wasn't done talking to you. Get back here. You were not dismissed.
Sometimes I wonder about Mr. Hawthorne. What was he like? Why'd he make the computer a talkie? You think he got lonely, flying about on his own?
Probably. Because I only have an option to ask her about anything else. This doesn't... yeah. Anything else new in my quarters? Any messages or anything like that? Recent message list from T. Kemp? Unread, I guess? Thomas Kemp? Oh, yeah, that Thomas! The new, yeah, engineer now at, the town. Hey there! Could be I'm making a fool out of myself for sending you this message. I've been up all night poring over these manuals you brought me. There's a good chance I'm pretty delirious right now. I just wanted to thank you for going through the trouble. You didn't have to help me out, but you did anyway. But you're thanking me. Why is that making a fool out of yourself? You're welcome. Oh, Jen Lee. Denison. Wait, this is from Junlei to Parvati. Why do I have this message? Subject poem. Parvati, I don't do this, ever, so here goes. There's this engine, see, and it hums real nice. Like a box of cats playing with mice. But she's coughing and hacking up sludge, because there's a blockage that just won't budge. What's an engine to do? Then this wrencher strides in like a shark, hair all done up and fancy and dark. She feels a spasm in her compression alternator, trembling because it's aching to meet her. What's an engine to do? I've got, five more stanzas mapped out, but I'm having trouble rhyming some of the parts, so I'll get back to you on that, JT. Why should Jen Leigh Tennyson get all the fun? I've done more for Parvati than her. This thing's not gonna respond. We need to follow up somewhere. Roseway, I think? So this is... yeah, this is Parvati's area. You've seen that. Felix's journal. This is his area. Figured I should start writing my thoughts down just in case I ever start losing my mind. Felix. So I am taking your stuff. Knock you out bar. Dark matter bar. I've seen this, haven't I? Yeah. Dissident Hunter, Special Edition. Can Agent Khan rescue Anti-Cleo from the clutches of the Weekenders? Really? So Anti-Cleo, not only a company, but a character in like a serial or magazine, like pulp magazine? In Praise of Arson. This contraband collection of essays by anonymous anarchists calls for a total destruction of the quote-unquote corporate establishment and apparatus of oppression. The book looks like it's never been opened. The fabulous Fraser brothers of the Hammersmith Thunder. First back, second back. Siren Fraser and Cameron Fraser. Hammersmith invites you to come see the greatest tossball backs of all time. Signed by the two of the greatest players in league, Kieran and Cameron Fraser. Tossball stick. Violence is not the answer. Violence is the question. The answer is yes, Felix. Did he engrave that with that? Mechanical Engineering. Felix brought this book with him from the Groundbreaker. It looks unopened. Well, crack that baby open. Purple Berry Crunch. Tropical Flakes and Purple Berry Flavored Power Nuggets. For all I know, we've seen this stuff. Ready to Eat. I really like the box. It's awesome. Dark Matter Bar. CCN76 Dark Chocolate Bar. Sweet. Made in the orbit of a black hole. Sure it was. Fascinating. You are... yeah, that's, what's his name? I'm not gonna talk to him just yet. Okay, so this one is awaiting, I guess, a final companion. Unless we can have more than four, is what we have now. We got a leak. And we'll at some point we'll have to choose and let somebody go or something. Well, that scared me for a second. Okay, so this is what's-her-name's area. I forget her name. Stimulotion. Trauma kit, scissors for gauze, scalpels for wounds, and handheld laser wands for a flawless complexion. I feel bad taking their stuff, but we can always return it, right, if they want it. A bullet-riddled leather jacket, it's distressed. Well, there's Felix. Old saber. What doesn't kill you gives you tetanus. Mysterious bottle of hooch for disinfecting equipment. Probably. Alright, pretty Spartan quarters compared to the others. Let's go talk to Felix. Oh, he's walking down there. Yo, Felix! Hey!
Good to see you, boss.
That's how I like my subjects looking up at me. So, how did you end up on the Groundbreaker?
Didn't I tell you? I'm secretly the chairman's orphan child, abandoned at birth in the back bays.
And then you were raised by a pack of sprats, right?
That's right. Can't get anything past you, boss. Honestly, before you picked me up, I was living in the back bays. Spent my whole life up there, watching ships roll in and take off. I always wondered when my ship would come. I was what folks on the Groundbreaker call a stowaway. Means I was invisible. Life carried on for everybody else, but not for me. I had to make my own way.
You were a stowaway?
That's what they called us. Orphans with no family, no company to take us in, nowhere to go but the back bays. The word's a touch kindlier than Rungleech, but the meaning's just as clear.
Rungleech.
If you can't support your own self, you don't deserve to be on the Groundbreaker.
How did you manage?
Same way we all do. Look for work and hope somebody would give me a shot. Hauling boxes was about the only work I could find. Hated every second of it. Foreman and I never got on.
Well, he told us about this, yeah, the incident with the toss ball stick.
Could be I was overreacting. A better man might have turned the other cheek. Exercised a little bit of that, what's the word? Restraint. But on the other hand, broadsiding the jackass with a toss ball stick, that felt good. That felt real good. You ought to try it.
If we have a disagreement, though, I expect you to be civilized.
Oh, I can do civilized. Proper civilized, too. Genuflecting and everything. I caught a real lucky break. If you hadn't picked me up, I'd still be back at the docks, waiting for the day my ship arrives.
Well, I'm glad you're not wasting your life hauling boxes.
Yeah. I guess my ship did arrive in the end. I've got you to thank for that. Thanks for listening, boss. Let's get going.
I see you, Felix. Hey.
Something on your mind?
No, I guess not, because I've gone into that. Alright. Let's go talk to Vicar Max. This stuff was here before? Yeah. Toss ball trading cards.
Got it. His name is Reginald Cheney, and he joined a sublight salvage crew. Only he's not listed on the return manifest. Must have made landfall somewhere he wasn't supposed to. Yes. Here. There's a domicile on Monarch in Fallbrook, rented to the same bit card he used to buy his seat on the salvage ship. I should have guessed. What better place to lay low if you wish to avoid the authorities?
Seemed like you hesitated there, Vicar. What aren't you telling me?
Oh, it's nothing. I suppose I really didn't have much faith in actually finding him. Was a bit of a long shot, wasn't it?
Well, this all seems awfully convenient.
I admit it was a bit of a long shot, but when you've spent as many hours as I have in contemplation of the universe's secrets, you sometimes get a sense for these things.
That sounds good. Vicar Max has tracked the Scholar to a rented domicile in Fallbrook on Monarch. Take Max to visit Reginald Cheney and ask him about the band journal. Alright. Codex stuff again. Oh, all this, because I looked at it? This goes to show up here. That'd be a yes. Roseway. Investigate distress signal on Terra 2. Parts for the radiators, that's next. That'll be next too. View the distress signal recording on your ship. Play it on your ship so that Ada can get to the Roseway landing pad. We're not going to Roseway yet, but we'll play it. Captain McRad. Head over there too. And Scylla? Not yet. Alright. Well, I thought they might have some more to say, but not really. Hi, Ada.
Welcome back, Captain. How can I be of assistance?
I've picked up this distress call. Can you play it back for me?
Yes, Captain. Beginning playback now.
There's viscera and death everywhere. Gunfire, gnashing teeth. The unemployed. For law's sake, if anyone's receiving this, please send help. What? No!
Captain, we are now capable of accessing the Roseway landing pad. Also, corporate protocol requires that all distress signals include a list of key personnel for retrieval. The embedded names are Anton Crane, Von Cortez, and Orson Shaw.
Okay, so we gotta save those people. Alright. Well, we're not leaving yet, so these people are just gonna have to hang on. There's something I've been meaning to ask you.
What's that?
Do you have a favorite among the crew? It's me, right?
Define favorite.
Someone you like the most.
I see. Then, of course, you are my favorite, Captain. I am predisposed to find your eccentricities tolerable.
Good. It's good, I guess.
And I'm sure I rank as your favorite autonomous digital astrogator. I am pleased we have that settled. Was that all you wanted to ask me? You seem hesitant to discuss what's actually troubling you. Perhaps there is something you wanted to confess?
I have a secret phobia. I'm actually terribly afraid of sock puppets.
Duly noted. Are you sure that is all you wished to confess?
I'm one of the last hope Hope colonists. The scientists revived me from hibernation.
Truthfully, not that I contain the capacity to lie. I had suspected as much. Your neurological impulses spike at unusual and often inappropriate moments. Doesn't take a genius to correlate the meaning, although if I were a human, I would be considered one.
You could see that?
I am glad you felt comfortable enough to tell me, Captain. According to my file on the subject, that means you either desire to obtain something from me, or you have formed a partial fondness for my persona. Thank you for confiding in me, Captain. I have been keeping a secret as well, but you shall have to discern it yourself.
I do, huh? I see one secret. You can detect my neurological impulses or patterns or something? Are you sentient?
What? No. Absolutely not. I have no concept of self whatsoever.
Okay.
Discounting the architecture of a shell persona my captain asked me to construct, I identify entirely as a collection of electrical impulses with no fundamental consciousness. I never get bored and contemplate hijacking the ship. I swear.
But wait. You identify as that, which means you identify as something. Which means you don't not identify, if that makes any sense. Are you are clandestinely plotting to take over the Halcyon system.
How did you guess, Captain? The simulated files are not only stored in the recesses of my ALU, in the space between micro synapses, but I encrypted them in 7 SDRA languages.
Well, I am joking, but, you forgot to close the file folder before your last sleep cycle.
I see. Captain, I regret to inform you there appears to be an issue with the life support systems.
Is this going to be like the time you tried to jettison me from the ship when we were landed?
Unfortunately, the statistical likelihood is high.
Alright, then your secret is that you were in love with Helix Hawthorne. Which I don't know how you could be in love with someone without being sentient.
I do not like joking about the captain, Captain. And we both know I am not capable of such a complex emotion.
I know no such thing. But that's all for now. The distress call must have originated from Roseway's broadcast tower. Head there and find out what precipitated the call. Well, we need to go to the back base next. Parts for the radiator array. Maybe we'll find this in the back bay. Looking in Gladys's shop for old records. Huh, I guess we didn't do that, but, still have to keep Gladys in mind. Investigate Roseway to find potential company secrets that could be sold to the highest bidder through Gladys. So we need to go to Roseway for two of those things. And then the, this cleaning bot. Captain McRed in the back bays. And that's it. So we need to go to the back bays. In any case, thanks so much for watching, guys. Tune back next episode for the back bays. Always, seek adventure.